Hey, Eves. Yesterday I had the awesome pleasure of handing out caps and gowns to our senior class. It was amazing to see so many of you and to be reminded why I got into education. I really love my job. I love my job because I love my students and all the amazing people I get to work with. I love my job because I get to come to this place every day and learn from you all. I'm so grateful for the lessons I've been taught by the students here at Skyline. One of the first lessons I learned at Skyline was that there are a lot of ways to be cool, and jumping hurdles when you don't know anything about jumping hurdles is not one of them. During my first month at Skyline, I thought it would be fun to jump a hurdle out on the track. I'll admit, I wanted to have a really cool object lesson for getting back up when you fall down. I knew I wasn't going to clear the hurdle the first time. What I didn't know is that I was setting up the hurdle backward and I was about to really hurt myself. I also wanted to make the student I was with smile. This experience taught me that there are a lot of ways to make people smile that don't require superhuman feats of strength. I still have no idea how people can jump hurdles. I can't emphasize this enough. Do not jump hurdles without proper training and safety measures. Over the last 2 years, the student I was with on that day taught me that she can get back up every time she's knocked down. I'm very grateful for her example. I'm grateful that she let me in and allowed me to be a part of her journey and learn from her. There are so many of you that I wish I could publicly praise for your resilience. One of the most powerful lessons I've learned as the school psychologist at Skyline is that there is a beauty that comes from tragedy. I saw this in the students who lost friends, and from that loss, developed empathy and a drive to help others. I will never forget the students who showed up in my office on a day I thought they would be hurting, only to offer support to other students who are hurting. It was one of the most beautiful, noble acts of kindness I've ever seen. I think of that moment a lot, especially now during this time of concentrated crisis. Despite the chaos, people who have a logical reason to despair seem to be rising up to face the challenges life throws at them and help others through their troubles. I know last week I read a poem, and I'm not going to make this a thing, but these students remind me of a poem that's on the wall of Mr. Bingham's office. The poem is called Invictus by William Ernest Henley. It says, "Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloodied but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade. And yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul." How do you become the master of your fate and the captain of your soul? Education. Never stop learning. And you don't know what you don't know, so keep looking, keep learning, keep exploring. You all have taught me so much, and I plan to continue to learn as much as I can from you. Be good, be safe, be eagles.